Hello and welcome to your astrological vibrations for Thursday, January 21st, 2021 by Gaia Blooming. I'm Mimi. Hello, and our energy mantra for today is I take time to nurture my vision and vibration. I was like, wait, where am I going with this? Holding vision, holding vibration. So I want to mention, I've been talking about this energy of this Mars-Uranus conjunction. And I know a lot of you have felt it. Now, just because we've reached the peak of it doesn't mean that it's quite over. So what we're building into now is Mars squaring Jupiter, and that will be on Friday evening late that we reach the peak of that. And so Jupiter's still feeding in. We have the moon, which is going to be amplifying some of these vibrations still some more as well. And so in this, I think sometimes after we reach like the peak of an intense transit, we can let our guard down. And I don't even like using those words, to let our guard down. And yet just realize that like that restlessness, the crazy that I've been talking about, that energy, it's still rising. And again, we don't live in a world where everybody believes the same things, but there are definitely a lot of, there's so much happiness right now, and then there's a lot of people who are really feeling frustrated with those who are happy. And so, again, some of this angst, some of that aggression is rising. And so your best bet is, again, listening to your intuition, letting that guide you, and just really working on holding that vibration of peace, that vibration of unity, that vibration of coming together, and tuning into your own personal sovereignty, your own personal intuition and messages. It's just so important. So, off camera, because these energies are very intense and I have had the worst headache all day. So just trying to take it easy for myself and yet still show up for you guys. So moon in Taurus, connecting to both Uranus and Mars super early in the morning. Moon and Mars energy often can bring about temper tantrums. Now, you know, Taurus energy is a lot more grounded. It takes a lot more to push a Taurus. Like, a Taurus isn't gonna like get mad at a drop of a hat. So if you find that energy building, chances are it is something that has been building within you and has needed a release valve. So if you've been feeling that incoming, how can you show up for yourself and offer yourself a release valve, whether the release valve is through self-care, self-love, nourishment, or even, again, feeding energy into your own personal vision. Moon will also be squaring Jupiter, which is building into this. Again, Jupiter just enhancing those energies. Again, this may also be part of what's needed. Again, we don't want to hold on to these things. We do want to process our emotions. E, energy, you know, like emotions, keeping these energies in motion. It's very important, rather than holding them, letting them volcano. And we do have that actually at the top of the cards. We have the miser. So just being very aware where there may be some energy that you've been holding on to. And again, the last several years have been very intense. The last few months have had a lot of intensity. That stuff builds up and we can't always process it in the moment. So again, where do you need to tend to yourself? I feel like that's part of the headache. It's like, okay, this has been a lot. I just need to rest. I just need some downtime. So you may be experiencing something similar to that. We also have the moon in Taurus connecting to Venus, a nice little trine. So again, the universe is like, yeah, we have these challenges, and yet the remedy is self-care. The remedy is showing up for yourself in the physical, really noticing what it is that you need. How can you nurture yourself? That's so funny, because that's where I was kind of going with the energy mantra. I had it, you know, in my head, like, okay, nurturing the vision and vibration, but I kept hearing like nurture and nourish, and I feel like that's what we in our human form kind of need right now as we embark on this new. That's part of that, you know, Mars Uranus energy is definitely embarking on this new path. So again, what's your vision? Peace, unity, working together for greater good, working together for the highest good, working together for the whole rather than just the individual. And we do that by honoring ourselves on that individual basis, getting beyond illusion. That's such a big one, and that's still up in the astro as well, with the south node being squared by Neptune, and Neptune For the states, Neptune is opposite, I believe, the United States Neptune. So we really want to be very aware of where illusion is popping up. Where does something not resonate with your core knowingness, your core truth, your core values? Keeping that in mind. So I'm going to leave that there for today. You can book a reading with me. Email me, mimiclark@gmail.com. It may take me just a few days to get back to you, as I'm just trying to be easy and gentle on myself as well. But besides that, the better it gets, the better it gets. There's more than enough love in the world for you. You have the power, and stay curious. Namaste.